In this Blender Python tutorial, we'll be creating and adding a simple panel into the sidebar of the 3D viewport. Hey, I'm Victor Stepanoff. I'll be guiding you through this Blender Python tutorial. Today, we're going to be defining a custom panel. It's going to be a very simple panel with a couple of buttons. We'll start off by telling Blender where we want to put this panel in the UI of Blender. Next, we'll give the panel a couple of labels so we can see that in the UI. We'll define the layout of the panel itself. We'll register the panel so Blender will know that it exists. And then finally, we'll wrap things up by creating an add-on. I'll also give you an exercise so you can start applying the knowledge you just learned. All right, let's get started. We'll start off by opening the scripting workspace, navigating up here and clicking new to create a new script. Now let me write down the steps using comments in the script. And here are the comments. So the very first thing will be importing BPY. It's a module that lets Python work with Blender's functionality. Next, we're going to be defining the panel itself. This is going to be a Python class, and then we'll be registering that Python class that defines our panel. All right, let's start filling in this class. Here's the class, and I'm inheriting from the panel type, and this will go under this class. And notice that I have a special naming convention. So the naming convention right here is the category, then the PT is panel type, and then the name of our panel. I'm just using my custom panel as the name. View3D is our category, and then the PT goes right here. And if you're feeling rusty with classes or are not really familiar with them, I have a separate video describing how you can use these classes in Blender. So check that out. Also, I need to import BPY right here so we can actually run the script. I'm gonna go ahead and run the script by hitting run right here, and nothing happens because we've just defined a class and imported BPY. So that's not gonna change anything in Blender. Let's tell Blender where we wanna put our panel. So I'm gonna do this right here. And we need to tell Blender the space type and the region type for that space. This is how I'm defining the space type and the region type. You must provide the space and region type in this format, so Blender is going to be looking for this in particular. And since we're adding our panel into the 3D viewport, I need to provide 3D view right here. And then I want to use the sidebar of the 3D viewport, and this is just going to be represented by UI. You can find a full list of all these parameters in Blender's documentation. I'll provide a link in the description. We don't need this more, and let's start defining the label for our panel. And the label for our panel will be defined with BL underscore label, and I'm just going to name it my custom panel label, and you'll see that this label at the top of our panel when we're going to add it into the UI. Next, we need to provide a single method that's going to be used to define the layout of our panel, and it's called draw. And we need to provide a self parameter and the context. And I'm going to make this comment as a documentation string, like so. And this should be enough for the basic setup of our panel. And again, if I run the script, nothing will happen. Nothing will change. We're still just defining this class. Blender has no idea that it exists. Let's start telling Blender that this thing actually exists, and let's add it into the UI. And to do this, we'll need to call the register command so Blender can put this panel where we asked Blender to do that. And I'm going to go down here and define the register and unregister functions. And here are the register and unregister functions. And we're calling the BPY utils register class. I'm using the class name right here to register it. And we need to provide an unregister class. So this will be called when we're going to be disabling our panel in the add-ons menu. Now we need to call this register. So we're going to be iterating right now in the text editor, and we need to call the register function to register and see the result. And I'm going to hide this register function call under this if statement. And let's go ahead and run our script and see how it appears. So I've targeted this sidebar right here, and we should see a new panel added right as I run the script. So let's do that. And look at that. We have this misc tab right here, and you can see that we have our my custom panel label, right? So this is exactly what we're defining right here. Let me just set that to 123 so you can see how this is updating and look at that. So, and this is exactly how we're changing that. All right, I actually want a custom label for this tab as well. And we can do that by also defining a category for our panel. So instead of MISC, it's gonna be whatever we write in that text. And here's how you define that. So BL underscore category, and then we provide some text right here, and that's gonna be the text that you're gonna see right here. Let's go ahead and run our script, and look at that. Now we have this text right here, so we can control that as well. And now it's time to define the layout of our panel. It's gonna be very simple. It's just gonna be buttons, but that's gonna be the base on which we're gonna be building the next tutorials that you're gonna see on this channel. We'll be connecting an existing operator, so I'm gonna be using the adding the cube into the scene operator. When we click on the button that we'll create, it's gonna add a cube into the scene. Very simple. I just wanna keep things very simple, and we're just defining the panel and the UI. In later videos, we're gonna be creating our custom operators that can perform custom actions, so stay tuned for that. So to create this custom layout, we're gonna define it in the draw method right here. And here is the code for that. So we're getting the layout and creating a new row, and then we're just adding an operator, and this is the name, the command that we're gonna be using. This is the operator itself, and it has the text for the button. And let's go ahead and check how did I actually get this. And let me clear the scene by hitting A, X, and then delete. And then I'm gonna hit Shift A, and then mesh, and then cube, right? And I'm gonna go into the info panel down below. And this right here is the command that adds the cube into the scene. Let me delete that. And let me just paste it in so you can see it alongside. And you can see that this is exactly right here, this piece of the command. It doesn't have the BPY ops, and we're just using this. All right, so let me delete that. Let me go ahead and rerun our script so we can update the UI of our panel. I'm gonna go ahead and run that. And look at that, now we have a button in our custom panel. Let's go ahead and run that, or hit that button, and look at that, it's adding the cube into the scene just as we wanted. And if you're enjoying this tutorial and learning something new, make sure to hit the like button so I can understand to make more videos like this. And as promised, I'll give you an exercise so you can do this on your own right now, and check back when you're done to see how I would have done it. I want you to add two more buttons to this custom panel. One of the buttons is gonna add an icosphere into the scene, and the other button is gonna shade smooth, right? So add those two buttons into this custom panel. I'll give you one tip, is that you'll need to define a new row like so to add a new operator button into this custom panel. So go ahead and pause the video now and try this on your own. And then once you're done, come back and see how I would have done it. Okay, to add those two buttons to our custom panel, it's pretty straightforward. Same thing that we did for the first button. And this code looks like this. And I got the operator code again from the info panel down below. The same thing for the shade smooth operator. Let me go ahead and run this script. And look at that, now we have three buttons in our custom panel. Let me delete everything from the scene. I'll add an icosphere, and then I'll zoom in and hit shade smooth, and look at that. I hope you like that exercise. And now to wrap things up, let's make this panel an add-on so we can enable it and disable it in the add-on menu. To do this, I'm gonna go to the very top of our script, and I'm gonna add a BL underscore info that defines the add-on information. And here is that BL info dictionary. And if you're not familiar with Python dictionaries, I have a video for that. I would recommend to check that out. But for now, all this information you will see in the add-on menus, the name of the add-on, the author, the version, the Blender, very important, the Blender version that this add-on supports. I'm going with an older version. Nothing in this add-on tells us that we can't support older versions of Blender. I'll provide the location, the description, and the category of the add-on. All right, so now with this in place, we're gonna save the script into a Python file, which has an extension of .py, and then we're gonna install it as you would any other Blender add-on. I'm gonna go right here and go into text and then save as. And I'm gonna open any folder I want save our add-on to. It doesn't really matter, you just have to just save it. I'm gonna call this mycustompanel.py, and I'm gonna hit save as right here. And now that is done, we can install this add-on. Let me go ahead and go into edit, preferences, and then hit the install button right here. And navigate to the folder that contains your add-on, and then select it and install add-on. And now we've successfully installed the add-on. You can see that all that information that we saw in the BL underscore info is right here. I'm gonna go ahead and restart Blender and to show you that our panel doesn't exist anymore. Okay, I'm back in Blender and you can see that we don't have our custom panel anymore. That means that we can enable it now. Let's go ahead and go into Edit, Preferences, and then search for our custom panel. And here is our panel. Let's go ahead and hit the enable box. And as soon as I hit that, we have our custom panel right here. And look at that, let's clear the scene. You can add the cube, you can add the icosphere, and of course you can shade smooth. Okay, next, check out this tutorial right here where I go over the process of creating another add-on. If you have any questions about this particular add-on, make sure to ask them in the comments, and thank you so much for watching.